And now we will learn the very last part of setting up QuickBooks for your home finance. Video 6, putting in income sources. Income accounts will go on the chart of accounts, and they will show you why and where the money came in from. However, customers are the people whom you received the money from. So, for example, if Joe Schmoe has four separate income sources, they would be listed this way: bartending job weekdays, bartending job weekends, landscaping, and bank account interest. For each of these four income sources, there's a person or a company that has to be put on the customer list so we know who the money is coming in from. For example, his weekday bartending job, he works for Molly's Saloon. However, his weekend bartending job, he works for the Beer and Go. Both of these are the names of the bars that he works for, but when he earns the money, it goes into bartending income. He does landscaping for a guy named Dave Parada, and of course, he gets bank account interest as one of his sources of income, and that would be Chase Bank. These four individuals would go on his customer list so he could track exactly how much money came in from each customer and find his transactions that way. Each of these four income sources would go in the same chart of accounts that we have been using all along, but they will be income type of accounts. Let's take a look at how to record this. First, we'll introduce you to the customer list in the Customer Center. From the main menu, click Customers, and the first choice is Customer Center. Notice it looks and behaves exactly like the Vendor Center. You can add the customers one at a time or in bulk. Let's add the first two one at a time. New customer, and here is the new customer window. And the first one will be Molly's Saloon. So we'll type in the field Molly's Saloon. And of course, we could put the phone number in case we forget, the phone number of where we work. And then when we click OK, you can see whatever information we put in to this field, whether it be address or email and so on, would show up here. For example, Molly at saloon.com. Now when I click OK, you can see this is part of Molly's information. And for each additional customer, all we have to do is click and we'll see that information. Let's add the next customer the same way. Beer and Go. New customer, Beer and Go. Now when we click OK, we can see there are two customers on the list. If I click on Molly, I'll get Molly's information. If I click on Beer and Go, I'll get Beer and Go's information. You can also add multiple customers at once by clicking up here and then click Add Multiple Customer Jobs. Notice these two are already here with the phone number or email put in, but you can just click here and then you can add Dave Parada. And of course, you could put his phone number, whatever the number is, and so on. And then the last one was Chase Bank. Remember, a company can be both a customer and a vendor because you can have money. See, it's warning you. The name is already on the vendor list. Okay, so let's just adjust it to Chase Bank Income so that the name is not exactly the same. And of course, save the changes. Click OK. Now we can see, if we click on the Beer and Go, we get that information. If we click on Chase Bank, we get that information. And Molly's Saloon is still the only one whose phone number and email address we have. You can use this as a Rolodex to scroll through to find the information from the people whom you need. Now all we have to do is put in the four income sources, or to be more specific, put in the three income sources on the account list in the same chart of accounts, put them in as income accounts, and once we're done, we'll be ready to move on to actually recording transactions. Let's make sure before we close the customer list that we put it up in the icon bar because we will always use it. View, view, add customer center to the icon bar. Click OK, and here you have it. So in the future, if you need to open it up, you click right here from the icon bar and you're ready to go. Now let's open the chart of accounts. From the left of the icon bar, click to open the chart of accounts. Just like we did in two previous videos, click Account New. But this time the type will be income. Click Income, click Continue. Double check that in the second window the type is income, and we will put bartending income. Save and new. What else does Joe have as income? Landscaping and bank account interest. So we'll put landscaping. Save and new. And bank account interest. Click Save and Close. Congratulations, you're all set up and ready to record transactions.